Young's deposit experiment. Suppose you are putting a glass slab over here of thickness T and refractive index mu. Getting it? You need to find out location of central maximum, where it is. When they start from here, there is no path difference, S1 and S2. What is the definition of central maximum?
Shift there. In this process of shifting, how many fringes will cross
the center line. As one thing you can derive later your own, that fringe width does not depend on mu. You can check yourself, like if you put this path difference is equal to n times lambda, you will locate for maxima. So then put n plus 1 and you subtract, this will disappear. So fringe width will be still how much?
So lambda divided.
Which D? Capital D or small D?
Lambda dp by small d.
This is the fringe width. Now tell me how many fringes will cross if you remove this?
So mu minus 1 t by lambda.
It will be mu minus 1 t d by d divided by fringe width. See how many, suppose n number of fringes are there between this. When you remove this, while it shifts here, these things will be shifted above here. So these fringes crossed the center line. Check it? Okay? So this is how much?
Mu minus 1 t by lambda.
This many. Fine. Does this need to be an integer? It need to be integer or not? Need not be. Need not be. Because at this point right now, there may not be perfect destructive or constructive difference. Are you getting it? If this point is where perfectly constructive destructive difference happens, then it will be integer. Otherwise not. Okay. Okay, so this is now similarly I can put, you know, here also and here also glass line. So whatever scenarios we have discussed, everything can exist. Let's take up another scenario. Draw a Young's emergent experiment. What is written? Draw this. You have a source over here. Okay? This distance is supposed d by 2. And this distance is d. Getting it? Find out location of maxima, central maxima, where it is. Everything else is same, right? This is d. Small d, wavelength is lambda.
How low is it?
In line with the slit. This is in line horizontally. First, tell me whether it is above or below. Central right line will be above or below. Simple with that, toss it up. Why?
So, the path is to be 0, right?
Hmm.
So, only when it's above will be equal.
Hmm. Check. So, if it is above, you can see. Now, you can say this plus this path is equal to that plus this. Otherwise, this wave from S1 is traveling more before also and after also. Fine. Find out this distance. How much is this? Y. Central right fringe. Where it is. How will I do this? Should I do it?
No.
Now I'll do it. Drop a perpendicular here. This is the path difference right now, and then you draw a perpendicular there. This is the path difference later. This is a hint. Now, can you do it?
So, does it necessarily have to be a rectangle?
No. Is this distance equal to that distance if it is central maximum? It has to be. This distance equal to that distance. And this angle is 90, this angle is 90. So approximately it becomes a rectangle actually. Yeah. But then will that help here? I don't think so.
So we can arrange theta sign.
Ah, so take it now. Part difference should be 0, no? So this is the part difference before and this is the part difference after. This has to be equal to this for this to be maximum. Now should I do it? So this is a center line for this point and that is a center line for this point B. Okay, this will be equal to this is D tan theta. Let's say this is phi. This will be D tan phi. Okay. So basically tan theta should be equal to tan of phi. Isn't it? This has to be equal to this for part difference to be equal to 0. Okay. So tan of theta is what? Tan of theta is this theta, so this is also theta, this is d by 2, this distance is d by 2, right? So d by 2 divided by capital D by 2. This should be equal to y by d. Fine. So y will be equal to small d. So where exactly? Y is equal to small d. This is d by 2. This distance is d by 2. D by 2 is above here. Will be central maximum. Any doubt on this? No? See, school level question you will be able to do it. No, it is straightforward. We are doing something else. We are just analyzing what all things can happen and what all things can be asked. Okay? Write down the one thing I missed actually earlier. Scenario number 3. When we are talking about scenarios now. So one more scenario is due to reflection. Write down reflection. Scenario number 3. Okay. Due to reflection, write down, due to the reflection, there will be an additional path difference of lambda by 2. Reflection introduces lambda by 2 path difference. Have we learned about this before? See, what happens is, suppose you take a string like this, okay, and this is a rigid support. When a wave goes like this, when it reflects off, it inverts. Fine, so after reflection, there is a phase difference of pi. And 2 pi corresponds to lambda, so pi corresponds to lambda by 2. So reflected wave has a path difference of lambda by 2. Okay, but then we have also learned that if it is this scenario, then reflected wave will be same. There is no phase difference. Okay, so here also scenario is not very straightforward. It's like if reflection, write down, reflection happens from denser medium, then it is lambda by 2. Okay, if reflection happens from the rarer medium, okay, if reflection happens from a rarer medium, then there is no path difference. Fine, it's like this. If light is already traveling in a refractive index of 1.5 and there is an interface after which it is 1 refractive index and total reflection happens, suppose. In every total reflection, there is no lambda by 2 phase path difference. Because total time reflection happens only when it is reflection from denser to rarer. Repeating it? But if it is a reflection when light travels from the rarer medium and then tries to go to the denser medium and reflection happens, then there will be lambda by 2 path difference. And in case of mirrors, there will always be lambda by 2 path difference. Fine? Because light never goes in. It totally reflects off. So we assume that that is the denser medium. Fine? In case of mirror, always lambda by 2 path difference. And in case when light is traveling from rarer to denser and get reflected off, lambda by 2 path difference. Okay? What?
You say rare and denser will be 0.
What?
Light travels from rarer to denser medium will be 0. Path.
No, no. If light travels from rarer medium and reflects off from denser medium, then there will be lambda by 2 path difference. And what is written here? Same thing is written here. But if light is traveling from denser to rarer medium and reflects off, there is no path difference. Is it clear? Fine. And during the reflection from the mirror, always lambda by 2 path difference. Fine.